Hello, I am Flash Isaac, and you are welcome to Flash Nana's Post-UTME series, episode 1, where you are prepared to pass Post-UTME in any Nigerian university, polytechnic, or colleges of education. In this episode, we shall be taking care of this question, which says, factorize s raised to the power of 3 minus 2s squared minus 5s plus 6. This question is under polynomial. And looking at this polynomial, the highest power of variable is 3. This is s raised to the power of 3. This is s raised to the power of 2. This is s raised to the power of 1. And here, there is s raised to the power of 0. We did not include it because s raised to the power of 0 is 1. And 6 times 1 is 6. So, we leave it here. When you are given any quadratic equation and asked to factorize or find the root, at the end of the solution, you will find two answers. You will say s is equals this or s is equals that. Why? The degree of a quadratic equation or expression is 2. Therefore, you will have two roots. Now, for a polynomial with degree 3, you will have 3 roots or 3 answers. In this question, we are not given any roots because in some questions, you'll be given one root or one factor and asked to look for the other factors. But in this case, we have to look for the 3 factors. How do we do that? This takes us to factor and remainder theorem. In this case, we shall focus on the factor theorem. Look at something. If I say 8 divided by 2, what would that give you? This will give you 4, right? Remainder what? 0. Which means, if you divide a particular number or value by its factor, you will get a remainder of 0. This is similar to factor theory, which says that, given the polynomial function of s, so if this polynomial divides s minus r, and the remainder is 0, it simply means that s minus r is a factor. Look at something. This polynomial expression is simply function of s, since we still have s here. So which means from here, function of s is equals s to the power of 3 minus 2s squared minus 5s plus 6. Now how about s minus r? S minus r is the divisor. It is dividing this polynomial. Now, r is a constant. Looking at these answers, these factors, you see s minus 1, s plus 2. So in this case, r is 1. In this case, r is 2. In this case, r is 3. In this case, r is 1, 2, 3, and so on. So minus must be there. It simply means that if this guy divided by this guy and the remainder is 0, therefore, this guy is a factor. What does that mean? If s, given s minus r, this is the same thing as s minus r is equals 0. This is the same thing as s is equals r. What does this mean? Any value of s you put here to give you 0. That is the first factor. So let's look for the first factor. In summary, we are given polynomials to factorize without giving you any of the factors. Simply look for the first factor. How do you do that? Look for any number. Substitute into this expression. Anyone that gives you 0, it means you've gotten the first factor. So let's take r as 1, which means let's say s is equals 1. Putting it here, we have function of 1, no longer function of s because we are using s as 1. This is equals 1 raised to the power of 3 minus 2. 1 squared minus 5 times 1 plus 6. Substitution. Anywhere you see s, put 1. Function of 1 is equals 1 minus 2 minus 5 plus 6. 1 raised to the power of 3 is 1. 2 times 1 raised to the power of 2 is 2. 5 times 1 is 5. So 1 minus 2 is minus 1. Minus 1 minus 5. You are owing minus 1, you borrowed another minus 5, that's minus 6. Now, 6 plus 6 is 0. What does that mean? When you substitute s equals 1 into this expression, the remainder is 0, which means s is equal to 1 is a factor. Now, s equals to 1 can be rewritten as s minus 1. What does that mean? If you take this 1 to the other side, it becomes negative. So s minus 1 is the fourth factor, which means this qualifies to be the answer. This qualifies, this qualifies, this doesn't qualify. What next? Before I proceed, take note of something. S plus 1 simply means s is equals minus 1, because you will have s plus 1 is equals 0. S will be equals 0 minus 1, that is minus 1. S minus 3 is the same thing as s is equals 3. Take note of that. To get the other two factors, we can continue guessing. You put any value, you put any value, anyone that gives you 0 is a factor. But take a look at something. What if the next factor is 6? Or what if the next factor is minus 5 or minus 3? This implies that you would have guessed up to like 10 times. Keep substituting, substituting before you get the other factors. That is time consuming. Therefore, after getting the first factor, use long division to get the other two factors. And to get the first factor, start substituting. You try 1. If it doesn't give you 0, you try 2. If it doesn't give you 0, you try 3. Before you try 1, 2, 3, substituting into the expression, you should get 0. It is easy to get the first factor. Since s minus 1 is a factor, it simply means that we use it to divide the polynomial. S raised to the power of 3 minus 2 s squared minus 5 s plus 6. This is the polynomial plus 6. We are using this guy, s minus 1, to divide the polynomial. How to do long division? Step 1, focus on the first guy. Then use this first guy to divide this first guy. S raised to the power of 3 divided by s, that should give you s raised to the power of 2, right? S raised to the power of 3 is s times s times s. Divided by s, 1s will cancel, leaving you with s times s to be s squared. Now, after this one, after getting your answer, put it at the top quotient. Use this answer to multiply everything here, to multiply s and minus 1. If it were longer, you still use it to multiply everything to have s squared times s, s to the power of 3, s squared times minus 1, that's minus s squared. After that, subtract to have 2 minus here. Here, s raised to the power of 3 minus s raised to the power of 3 is 0. Minus 2s squared minus s squared. So take note of sign here. Minus 2s squared minus s squared. That will give you minus 2s squared minus times minus plus s squared. So minus 2s squared means you are owing 2s squared. Plus 1s squared means you paid 1s squared. Meaning you still be owing 1s squared, which is s squared minus. So nothing here. So this remains minus 5s plus 6. Because minus 5s minus 0 is minus 5s. Plus 6 minus 0 is plus 6. It remains. Now, here is 0. We can choose to remove the 0 because it means nothing. If you understand up to this point, be happy because you now understand everything about long division. The next steps will be repetition of the first steps. So you mark this first guy, you mark this first guy. This first guy divided by this first guy, minus s squared divided by s is minus s. Using this minus s to multiply everything, you have minus s squared, minus s times minus 1, that is plus s. Then you rule, you subtract. Minus s squared minus s squared. That is minus s squared plus s squared. 0, right? Minus 5s minus plus s. That is minus 5s minus s. Minus 6s. Plus 6 remains. So here is 0. You can choose to click only the 0. We still have s here. you follow the same pattern.
This first guy and this first guy. Minus 6s divided by s, that is minus 6. Using minus 6 to multiply everything here, minus 6 times s is minus 6s. Minus 6 times minus 1 is plus 6. You subtract. Minus 6s minus minus 6s, that is minus 6s plus 6s, 0. Plus 6 minus plus 6, that is 6 minus 6, 0. You see? So, the remainder is 0. This is a factor. Which means from this quotient, we'll get the other two factors. What is that? S squared minus s minus 6 is a quadratic expression. So, when you factorize a quadratic expression, what happens? You get two roots. Two roots plus the one root is equals what? Three roots. So, from here, we'll get the other two roots. Now, I know you are familiar with quadratic equation. If you are not, this is it. You have s squared minus s minus 6. This is the middle one. This is the same thing as minus 1s. Here is minus 6. You look for two values. That when you add, you get minus 1. When you multiply, you get minus 6. Since here is 1. It's very easy. You know that looking at 2 and 3. If it's plus here, 2 plus 3 is 5. It won't work. Minus. 2 plus minus 3 is the same thing as 2 minus 3, that is minus 1. 2 times minus 3 is minus 6. So that qualifies. Here you say s squared minus 2, no, plus 2s. 2 is positive, 3 is negative. Minus 3s minus 6. So here we've not changed anything because 2s minus 3s is the same thing as minus s. We just expanded. Now, grouping 2, 2, when you group here and here, s squared and 2s, s is common. So you pick 1s and say s squared divided by s, you are left with s, plus 2s divided by s, you are left with 2. Then minus 3s and minus 3. Minus 3 is common because minus 3 can divide both of them. So you bring out minus 3. Minus 3s divided by minus 3. Minus 3 will cancel minus 3, leaving behind s. Minus 6 divided by minus 3, that is plus 2. So, plus s plus 2, s plus 2, they are common. We pick 1, s plus 2. What is remaining outside? S minus 3. So, the first factor, the second factor, and the third factor, which means s minus 1, s plus 2, and s plus 3 are the factors of the polynomial s to the power of 3 minus 2s squared minus 5s plus 6. So that is it. I hope you found this lesson helpful. I am Flash Isaac. Don't fail to subscribe so you don't miss out any of the other series. And feel free to check out my previously released video. Thank you. That is it.